Hello, music people. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can route audio directly from Logic Pro 10 into Zoom using a software program called BlackHole. Doing this will allow you to bring audio from Logic into Zoom without any additional latency. It's a great little software program, and by the way, you can route audio between all kinds of different programs, but I'm just going to be focusing on how you can connect Logic to Zoom. So you'll go to this website, existential.audio/blackhole, enter in an email address, first name, last name, and click subscribe. Then within a couple minutes, you will get an email that looks like this. You'll click on the download link. You will download it. When you download it, the file you get will look like this. You can double click on it, and then you'll just keep pressing continue, and it will install the software program. And what's interesting about it is that it will not show up in your applications list. It's not that kind of a program. Instead, where it will show up is in your audio MIDI setup, which you can get to by clicking Finder, click on Go, Utilities, Audio MIDI Setup. And you'll notice a new slot here called Black Hole. You can download the 2-channel or 16-channel version. I downloaded the 16-channel version. And once you're here and setting things up, there's a few different ways that you can go about doing it. And I'm going to show you the simplest way to set things up so that you can route audio from Logic to Zoom. What you'll want to do is you'll want to create a multi-output device, as I've done here. And I'll create another one just to show you how to do it from scratch. Click on the plus sign down here and then click Create Multi-Output Device. And you'll want to select your audio interface. This is mine, EIE. And you'll want to select Black Hole. And I recommend you click both these two boxes for drift correction. And that's it. I'm just going to remove this one. And then when you are ready to run audio from Logic into Zoom, you'll want to select the multi-output device here by right-clicking. Oh, not like that. You can rename it that way. But if you right-click more around in this area and then click on Use This Device for Sound Output, then you'll be good to go. And so now let's go into Logic here. And what you'll want to do is click on Logic Pro X, Preferences, Audio, and you will want to select your audio interface as an input, and your output device will be the multi-output device that we just set up. And what that multi-output device does is basically it takes everything coming out of the stereo out here and brings it to two places. It brings it to your audio interface, and so you can use your interface at home to monitor the sound coming out of Logic. You can plug headphones into your interface's output, or you can use speakers. If you're doing stuff over Zoom, I recommend headphones though. It is also outputting everything from the stereo out into Black Hole, and we are using Black Hole to go straight from Logic into Zoom without any additional latency. So you'll need to set things up properly in Zoom as well. So I've got my Zoom session running already. Here I am. And you'll just want to click the upward pointing arrow next to the microphone. And you will want to select Black Hole as your microphone. You're selecting that as your input. So you're going out of Logic to Black Hole, and then Black Hole is coming in as an input into Zoom. And so, because I've set it up that way, when I play this track in Logic, you will hear it in Zoom. Take a look at the microphone out, the microphone icon, while I'm playing this. So I wasn't talking, and you can see that that this input monitor here was going up and down because Zoom was hearing what was happening in Logic. And so what you can do, in addition to playing back music like this, is you can set up a channel like I've done here. I've got my microphone plugged in. You'll just have to make sure that I is selected for input monitoring so you can actually hear it. And I've just got I don't have anything turned on right now in the channel strip, but you know, I can turn on EQ. I can make changes to it in real time that you can hear, that everyone in your Zoom meeting will be able to hear. You can add reverb, like I'm doing here. You can add delay. You can add both reverb and delay. And then you could sing along with audio backing tracks that you've got loaded up in Logic. If you're a guitar player or a keyboard player, you could plug your guitar or keyboard in. Guitarists could use amps and effects that are built right into Logic, and it will be sent straight to the Zoom session, again, without any additional latency. So it's pretty great. But just a reminder, though, that as soon as you are done doing that, as soon as you're done the Zoom session and you just kind of want to return your computer the way to what it normally is, you'll want to go back into the audio MIDI setup area and deselect the multi-output device and instead return to your interface or your built-in output or whatever, because the multi-output device just doesn't work so well with other programs. QuickTime Player, for example, won't play back videos if a multi-output device is selected. So there you go. Hope this video has been helpful, and I will see you next time.